哈利路亚，各位弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Hallelujah, may peace be with all brothers and sisters.
感谢主耶稣的恩典，在这个晚上，让我们一同聚集在这里学习圣经上的道理。
Thanks to the grace of God that we can all gather tonight to learn the words of the Bible.
今天也是这个青年灵恩会的开始的第一天。
And tonight is the first day of our young adult spiritual convocation.
求主耶稣能够继续带领在接下来这两天当中的安排跟活动。
May the Lord continue to guide the activities that will occur these next couple of days.
那在这一次的青年灵恩会当中有立下一个主题。
Now there is a theme for this young adult spiritual convocation.
这主题就是让我们一起起来建造。
And the theme is, let us rise up and build.
那这句话是从尼希米记当中所出来的。
And this phrase is from the book of Nehemiah.
我觉得这一个主题选得很好。
And I think that this is a very good theme.
尤其是适合我们在现在这个时候来思考这个问题。
And especially in these times, it's very important for us to think about this problem.
从疫情开始以来到现今已经将近两年。
It's been about 2 years since the beginning of the pandemic till today.
这两年当中有了许许多多的改变，我们的生活习惯，我们的聚会习惯都有许多的不同。
And in these 2 years, many of our habits have changed, whether it's in our lifestyle or in our service.
因为疫情的关系，所以教会必须要先暂时关闭。
Because of the pandemic, the church was closed temporarily.
那人跟人之间的互动或者是团契基本上减到最少。
And our interactions and fellowship were cut to the minimal.
但是随着这疫情逐渐的控制，
But as the pandemic was slowly controlled,
教会逐步的开放，事工渐渐的恢复。
Churches began to open and our worship services began to start again.
这个时候我们却看到不同的信徒有着完全不一样的反应。
And in this time, we saw that different members had different types of reactions.
有的信徒迫不及待地要回到会堂来见面聚会，并且跟大家团契。
Some members couldn't wait to come back to church, see everyone, and fellowship with each other.
有的人则是仍然顾虑重重，有点担心，而不敢迈入人多的地方。
Whereas others were worried and fearful of going to places where there were many people.
当然每一个人有不同的考量，有不同需要担心的事。
Of course, everyone has their own considerations and things to be afraid of.
但是有时候当习惯成为自然，当在家里聚会取代了回到会堂的选择。
But a habit became very natural, so that worshiping at home became the natural choice instead of going to church.
对有些人来讲，这个不来，没有回到会堂，或者是不再参与圣工，成为了他生活的新态度。
And for some people, not returning to church and not serving became a new choice in their life.
可能会自我安慰说，我是因为安全的缘故。
And we may say to ourselves, we're doing this out of safety.
但是蛮有趣的，如果你去看看他的脸书，也出去旅行，也家族聚餐，也跟朋友 hang out, 他样样都没有关系。
But interestingly, when you look at these people's Facebooks, you'll find that they still go out to eat, go on vacation, and gather with their family members.
但是遇到教会、事工、团契，那则是忧心忡忡。
But when it comes to servitude, fellowship, and going back to church, they are full of worries.
所以这是我们每一个人都要逐步的去思考自己的信仰。
So this is something we need to reflect upon in our own faiths.
有的人是因为家里有老有小，他是真正的担心。
There are some people who are truly worried because their homes are have people who are either elderly or very young.
有的人只是因为习惯而不愿意站起来重建他的信仰。
While others, out of habit, are unwilling to rise up and build their faiths.
但是不管如何，神都知道。
But no matter what, God knows all.
所以这是一个很好的让我们大家重新自我检视自己信仰的机会。
And so this is a great opportunity for each and every one of us to really reflect on our faiths.
当以色列人这个以色列人得罪了神。
When the Israelites sinned against God.
到最后他们的结果就是在神的愤怒当中失去了自己的国家。
In the end, they lost their kingdom because of God's wrath.
所以国家被毁坏，百姓被掳走。
Their kingdom was destroyed and the inhabitants were taken into captivity.
到了这个尼希米的时代。
When it came to the time of Nehemiah,
这里告诉我们说百姓受欺压，圣城城门被焚烧。
It tells us that the people were oppressed and the walls of the city were destroyed.
耶路撒冷是他们的荣耀。
Jerusalem was their glory.
圣殿是他们信仰的中心。
And the temple was the center of their faith.
但是在这个最糟糕的时代。
But in this most terrible time,
他们的城墙被拆毁，城门被火焚烧。
The walls of their city were destroyed and the gates were burned.
看起来是绝望而黑暗的时期。
It seemed like a very hopeless and dark time.
但是神却兴起了最耀眼而有能力的工人。
But the Lord rose up very capable workers.
这就是在每一个人人生的选择引到了不一样的道路。
And this comes down to each individual's choice, and it brings them to a different path.
那我们今天晚上就用尼希米记的一段来做彼此的学习。
Tonight we're going to use a passage in the book of Nehemiah as our mutual encouragement.
我们请翻到尼希米记的第一章。
Let's look at Nehemiah chapter 1.
第一章的第一节。
Chapter 1, verse 1.
哈加利亚的儿子尼希米的言语如下：亚达薛西王二十年，基斯流月，我在苏珊城的宫中。第二节
，Verse two，
那时有我一个弟兄哈拿尼，同着几个人从犹大来。我问他们那些被掳归回、剩下逃脱的犹大人和耶路撒冷的光景。第三节
，Verse three。
他们对我说，那些被掳归回剩下的人在犹大省遭大难，受凌辱，并且耶路撒冷的城墙拆毁，城门被火焚烧。第四节
Verse 4。
我听见这话，就坐下哭泣，悲哀几日，在天上的神面前禁食祈祷。在这里是尼希米记的开端。
This is the beginning of Nehemiah.
也是画下尼希米传奇人生的开始。
And also laid down the rest of the life of Nehemiah.
在这里我们知道这个耶路撒冷遭遇大患难。
We see that Jerusalem faced a great tribulation.
而尼希米听到了这个消息。
And Nehemiah heard of this news.
尼希米他并不是在犹大地长大的人。
Nehemiah did not grow up in the land of Judah.
所以他是在外国长大，其实跟犹大、耶路撒冷、圣城并没有太大的关联。
He grew up outside of Judah, and so in reality, he had no real relationship with Judah and Jerusalem.
而且这里讲到尼希米在苏珊城的王宫当中。
It also tells us here that Nehemiah was in in Shushan, the citadel.
告诉我们这个尼希米。可是人上人，可是事业有成的成功人士。
And this tells us that Nehemiah was a very successful man.
但是在这里却告诉我们，尼希米关心耶路撒冷，虽然他从来没有去过。
And it tells us here that although Nehemiah had never been to Jerusalem, he was concerned about it.
他关心自己祖宗的家园，他关心他们信仰的中心。
He was concerned about the center of their faith and the home of his ancestors.
所以他就问问啊，这个从犹大来的说，这耶路撒冷状况如何呢？
And so he asked the men who came from Judah concerning what was going on in Jerusalem.
在这里当他听到了一个极度恶劣的消息。
And he heard a very terrible news.
结果就是他放声大哭，向神祈求啊。
When he heard these words, he sat down and wept and mourned for many days.
这就是尼西米整个传奇人生的开始。
And this is the beginning of the rest of the life of Nehemiah.
今天我们希望活出一个不一样的人生来。
We all want to live a different life.
能够在神面前有价值，能够活的一辈子有意义。
We want to live a life of value in the sight of the Lord, a meaningful life.
他第一个就是要求要你关心神家的事。
And to do so, the first requirement is to be concerned about the matters of the house of God.
我们刚刚说过，尼西米他没有到过犹大，也没有去过耶路撒冷。
We already said that Nehemiah had never been to Judah or Jerusalem.
他也不是在这犹大地所生，他是 这个国外出生长大的。
And he was not born in Judah, he was born in a different country.
虽然没去过，但是他很在乎。
Even though he had never been to Judah, he was very concerned about it.
因为那可是他列祖列宗的土地。
Because that is the land of his ancestors.
那可是犹大人的圣城。
And it was the holy city of Judah.
那可是他们的祖宗亚伯拉罕的神所拥有的圣殿。
And it was where the God of Abraham had his temple.
所以他虽然没有过虽然感觉从人的眼光来看跟他没有任何的关系。
Therefore, even though in the sight of man, this place had no relation to Nehemiah.
但是因为他把神的事放在心中，所以神就为他铺出了一条不一样的道路。
But because Nehemiah put the matters of God in his heart, God gave him a different path in his life.
这就是尼西米传奇人生的第一步。
And this is the first step of Nehemiah's life.
从这在乎神的家、神的殿开始。
It came from first being concerned about the house of God, the temple of God.
接下来我们看回来尼西米记的一章第六节。
Let's also look at Nehemiah chapter 1, verse 6.
第六节。
Verse 6.
愿你睁眼看，侧耳听，你仆人昼夜在你面前，为你众仆人以色列民的祈祷，承认我们以色列人向你所犯的罪，我与我的父家都有罪了。在这里，尼西米在痛哭当中向神祷告。
Here, Nehemiah in bitter tears prayed to the Lord.
他向神祷告说，求你垂听，求你帮助，求你赦免我们的罪。
He prayed to the Lord, please listen to our prayer, please help us, please forgive our sins.
我们刚说过，其实尼西米根本不是在犹大地所生。
We already said that Nehemiah was not born in Judah.
所以犹大人所犯的罪，过去所得罪的神的事，其实跟尼西米一点关系都没有。
Therefore, Nehemiah had nothing to do with the sins of those in Judah.
但是在这里我们看到他所说的是，我与我父家都有罪了。
But Nehemiah says here, both my father's house and I have sinned.
有时候人都喜欢把责任归咎在别人的身上。
Oftentimes, man likes to place the blame on others.
千错万错都是别人的错。
Everything is wrong and it's always everyone else's fault.
我都有理由，我都有原因。这个有错都跟我没有关系。
I have my own reasons. No matter what, if there's something wrong, it's not my fault.
就好像在撒母耳记上里面的扫罗王一样。
Just like Saul in the book of Samuel.
我们看到扫罗，他每次只要出了问题，就说都是百姓的错。
We saw that when anything happened with Saul or any problem happened, Saul would always say it is the people's fault.
所以神并不喜悦他。
And so the Lord was not pleased with him.
甚至后来厌弃他作王，将他废弃。
And despised him and would not allow him to be king.
我们来看箴言的第二十八章。
Let's look at Proverbs 28.
箴言二十八章的第十三节。
Proverbs 28:13.
十三节。
Verse 13.
遮掩自己罪过的必不亨通，承认离弃罪过的必蒙连续请念。
He who covers his sin will not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy.
在这里让我们知道说我们要得到神的怜悯跟恩典，必须要承认自己是有罪的。
Here tells us to receive the mercy and grace of God, we need to confess that we are sinful.
要看到自己的软弱，才知道需要神的帮助。
Only when we see our weaknesses can we know that we need the help of God.
所以我们看到圣经里面这些逃避责任，这个遮掩罪过的，都是令神不喜悦的。
So we see in the Bible those who ran away from responsibility and would not admit their sins and faults were despised by God.
就像我们刚说的扫罗，或者是讲到亚伦也是一样。
Just like Saul that we mentioned earlier and Aaron.
这个亚伦做大祭司。
Aaron was a high priest.
但是却为百姓铸造了金牛犊。
Yet he also made the golden calf for the Israelites.
摩西很生气，摩西说你做这是什么事呢？
And Moses was very angry and said, why did you do this?
结果亚伦说，与我何干啊？这个百姓弄出来的，不是我的责任。
And Aaron said that it has nothing to do with me, it came out by itself.
结果圣经告诉我们，神很生气，神要杀亚伦啊。
The Bible tells us that the Lord was so angry he wanted to kill Aaron.
所以我们看到尼西米在面对这个遇到灾祸，他并没有把自己这个站在外面做旁观。
So we see that when there was trouble going on, Nehemiah did not stand in the corner and just look.
没有站在那里伸出指责的手说，就是你们这些坏人，害我们今天这么可怜。
He didn't stand by the side and point fingers at everyone else and say that it's all because of you that we are in this situation right now.
他说，我和我的父家得罪了神。
He said, both my father's house and I have sinned.
所以当人在神面前谦卑，
When man is humble in the sight of God,
就能够看见神的恩典跟怜悯。
Then they will see the mercy and the grace of God.
我们看回来尼希米记的第二章。
Let's go back to Nehemiah. Let's look at chapter 2.
尼希米记的二章的第四节。
Nehemiah chapter 2 verse 4.
第四节，王对我说，你要求什么？于是我默祷天上的神。第五节。
5.
我对王说，仆人若在王眼前蒙恩，王若喜欢，求王差遣我往犹大到我列祖坟墓所在的那城去，我好重新建造。在这里尼希米不是只有痛哭流涕祷告而已。
Here Nehemiah did not only pray and weep with tears.
在这里说他向神祷告求好机会，并且告诉国王他要到犹大去。
He prayed to the Lord and asked for a good opportunity, and he said to the king that he wanted to go to Judah.
对你我来讲，这个选择感觉还蛮好的啊，给他拍拍手，好棒。
To you and I, we might feel that Nehemiah made a good choice, and we might applaud him and say he was great.
但是其实要做下这个决定，对尼希米绝对不简单。
But for Nehemiah to make this choice was definitely not easy.
尼希米努力了多久才成为波斯帝国当中的大官？
How long did Nehemiah have to toil for to be, become a great, officer in the land of Persia?
能够成为波斯王的好朋友。
To become a good, friend of the king.
成为国王最信任最亲近的人。
To be someone that, one of the most closest people to the king.
这是他的事业，这是他的人生，这是他努力一辈子所得到的价值。
This was his career, his life's work, the value of his life.
在一个强大的帝国，在这个皇宫当中，能够陪伴在国王的身边。
Now, in the strong kingdom, he was able to be by the side of the king in his palace.
但是在这里，尼希米必须要做一个人生重大的选择。
But Nehemiah here had to make the biggest decision of his life.
好，你听到了耶路撒冷被火焚烧。
Yes, you've heard that Jerusalem has been burned with fire.
好，你听到了犹大百姓在那受苦。
Yes, you have heard that the people in Judah are suffering.
好，你已经禁食祷告在神面前痛哭流涕。
Yes, you have already fasted and prayed and wept bitterly in the sight of God.
然后呢?
Now what?
很多时候人觉得我做到这样已经仁至义尽，已经非常的好了。
Oftentimes, we think that when we've done this, it's already good enough. That's all we need to do.
我祷告啦，我交托啦，我把神放在，我把事情放在神的面前啦。
I've already prayed. I've already handed everything into the hands of God.
我悔改啦。
I've repented.
哦，我已经禁食啦，你还要我怎么样？
I've even fasted. What more do you want me to do?
有时候我们把所谓的祷告跟禁食成为一种逃避的盾牌跟借口。
Oftentimes we use prayer and fasting as an excuse to avoid responsibility.
啊，但是尼希米并不是这样。
Nehemiah was not like that though.
他祷告向神认罪悔改。
He prayed and confessed his sins to God.
他禁食求神引导他的脚步跟方向。
He fasted and prayed and asked the Lord to guide his footsteps and direction.
所以他跪下哭泣祷告。
And so he knelt and prayed bitterly.
但是他站起来得到勇气能够做出一个不一样的人生抉择。
But he stood up and had the courage to make a different choice in his life.
啊，他跟王说，我要到犹大。
He told the king, I'm going to Judah.
我要回去重修我祖宗的城。
I want to go back to my father's home so I may rebuild it.
这样的选择是要放弃他人生所经营长久得到的事业跟成功。
To make this choice, Nehemiah would have to give up his life's work and success.
但是他愿意付出代价。
But Nehemiah was willing to pay the price.
啊，所以我们的弟兄姐妹，今天我们希望走出一个不一样价值的人生。
So brothers and sisters, today we want to have a different value in our life.
啊，他不是啊，跪下来祷告一下，或者是参加个讲习会就可以的。
And it's not that just attending a seminar or kneeling down to pray is enough.
啊，平常有聚会啊，然后随手做点圣工。
And going to service regularly and occasionally serving God.
啊，其实他常常是需要人生必须有重大的抉择。
Actually, it often requires that we make a important choice in our life.
而这个抉择常常是需要你在痛苦当中付出代价的。
And this choice often is sacrificing something.
啊，这尼希米他可以做不一样的选择啊。
Nehemiah could have made a different choice.
啊，他可以继续留在王宫。
He could have stayed in the palace.
啊，反正我已经哭过祷告过了。
I mean, I've already prayed and cried to God.
剩下的就是神交托给神啦。
I'm going to leave the rest to God. That's it.
啊，我继续工作啊，我继续祷告啊，我继续看神怎么样开路。
I will continue working. I will continue praying, and I'll continue seeing how God opens the way.
啊，但是尼希米的祷告是求神赐他力量，然后引导他的方向。
But Nehemiah's prayer was to ask God to give him strength and to guide his next step.
然后求神给他勇气，能够走上不一样的道路。
And to ask God to give him the courage to walk this different path.
虽然这样子的道路要他付出极大的代价。
And even though this path required him to make a very large sacrifice.
放弃他的事业。
To give up his career.
远离陪伴在君王身边的机会。
To leave this opportunity of being close to the king.
然后到一个乡下一文不值的地方，在那里盖房子。
And to go to a rural area and build houses.
啊，这就是他的选择。
This was his choice.
也是他今天被记在圣经，还有被记在神心中的一个原因。
And this is why he is remembered in the Bible, and he is remembered in God's heart.
啊，所以按照他的按照他的行动啊，神也给他机会，他就啊得到了王的应允。
And because of Nehemiah's actions, God gave him.Opportunity and the king allowed him to do this.
那所以他终于有机会来到了耶路撒冷。
So Nehemiah finally had the opportunity to go to Jerusalem.
我们来看尼希米记的第二章。
Let's look at Nehemiah chapter 2.
第十一节。
Verse 11.
尼希米记的二章第十一节。
Nehemiah 2:11.
我到了耶路撒冷，在那里住了三日。十二节。
12.
我夜间起来，有几个人也一起起来，但神使我心里要为耶路撒冷做什么事，我并没有告诉人。除了我骑的牲口以外，也没有别的牲口在我那里。十三节。
13.
当夜我出了谷门，往野狗井去，到了粪场门，查看耶路撒冷的城墙，见城墙拆毁，城门被火焚烧。我们看第十六节啊。
Verse 16.
说我往哪里去，我做什么事，官长都不知道。我还没有告诉犹大平民、祭司、贵胄、官长和其余做工的人。啊，在这里告诉我们，尼希米来到了耶路撒冷。
Here it tells us how Nehemiah came to Jerusalem.
啊，作为一个原本在苏珊城国王身边的大官大臣。
He came from the palace in Shushan, a very large city.
啊，来到这个小地方耶路撒冷啊，这个破旧的城池。
And he came to this broken down city of Jerusalem.
啊，对这耶路撒冷的人来说，尼希米是高高在上、走在云端的一个大人物啊。
And to the people living in Jerusalem, Nehemiah was a high official, as high as the clouds.
啊，他在这里可以得到最好的，拥有最强大的，拥有最好的，能够有最舒适的一切啊，这个啊，所有的好处。
And he could have had all the best of the land and been in the most comfortable environment.
啊，但是在这里说，他休息了三天之后，却一个人晚上这个去巡视耶路撒冷的破损跟所遭到的毁坏。
But it says that after he might have rested for 3 days, he arose in the night to look at the destruction of Jerusalem.
啊，他这里讲说，我往哪里去，我做什么事，官长都不知道的。
And he said that what he did, no one knew about, none of the officials knew.
啊，但是他借着这样啊，这个单独的巡视，已经知道了耶路撒冷的状况。
But by going alone, he was able to understand the situation in Jerusalem.
啊，虽然啊啊，这里说有几个人跟哦，这应该是他的仆人呐、啊，啊，他自己的身旁的侍卫跟仆人。
It does say that there, even though there were people who came with him, they were all, most likely his servants.
啊，但是在这，他并没有带着官长或者是这些啊，这个贵胄啊，这个来跟着他一起巡视。
But he didn't bring the nobles or the officials to go and survey with him.
啊，为什么他会做这样的事情呢？
So why would he do this?
啊，因为如果带着贵胄、带着官长，这个大张旗鼓的。啊，这个要做这个大张旗鼓的宣告，常常你所看到的不见得是真实的状况。
Because if he had gone with the nobles and the officials, these high officers, he may not have been able to see the true situation of the time.
啊，如果你是贪图享乐，留在这个舒适的旅馆，等着官长跟你报告，你所听到的、看到的，只是他们要你看见的。
If you were to stay in your comfortable hotel and wait for your servants to come tell you what is the situation, or the officials to tell you what's the situation, you're only going to hear what they want to tell you.
啊，但是尼希米是一个做事的人。
But Nehemiah was a man of action.
所以他希望看到真实的状况，他希望了解真正的问题。
He wanted to see the true situation and see what the true problem was.
所以他宁愿在夜晚无人的时候，自己亲眼看，自己亲手摸，才知道状况在哪里。
Therefore, he was willing to, in the middle of the night, go by himself and see with his own hands and touch with his, see with his own eyes and touch with his own hands, what was the situation?
啊，如果我们今天很喜欢什么事情都是热热闹闹、轰轰烈烈、一大群人。
If today we like to constantly be amongst many people,
啊，少了那个安静的时间，能够仔细看，能够认真想。
Then we are lacking that alone and quiet time to truly reflect and think.
啊，那很容易我们会受到啊这个蒙蔽啊，我们看不到事情的真相。
Then we will easily be blinded and not see the true situation.
那所以当我们在神学院的时候，老师都会特别提醒我们。
So when I was in TTP, the teachers would often remind us.
说当我们被分派到地方教会协助教会工作的时候。
That when we are sent to different churches to help with their holy work.
不要急匆匆的这个一把的一股的热情，一股心中的热火这个我要改正这个，我要调整那个。
Don't go in with this heart of fervor saying that I want to change this and I want to implement this.
我要改革，我要做什么重大的变动。
I want to make this large change in the church.
因为其实你什么都不知道，你什么都不懂。
Because in reality, you don't know anything and you don't understand anything.
有时候你听到的也不见得就是事情的真相。
And even though you hear of things, they might not be the true situation.
有时候有的信徒来跟你讲这个事情，这个事情，这个人怎么样。
Sometimes members will tell you, this is going on and this member is like this.
如果你听见就相信，相信了就行动到最后常常让自己成为一个傻瓜。
If you hear it and believe it, and believe it and take action, then oftentimes you will become a fool.
因为你不知头，不知尾，也不知道到底发生了什么事。
Because you don't know the head or the tail, and you don't actually know what's going on.
那所以人要学会安静。
So we need to learn to be quiet.
在安静当中，用心观察，来看到真正需要你帮助的地方。
In quietness, observe and see where we truly can help.
好像尼西米这样走一圈，亲眼看，亲手摸，才知道问题的症结。
Just like Nehemiah here, he saw with his own eyes and felt with his own hands and was able to understand it.
同时也是提醒我们今天参与教会的圣工。
And this also is a reminder for us in our servitude in the church.
我们如果只是发号施令，站着。叫别人去做事。
If we are often just delegating others to do work.
但是没有亲自的去体会，亲身的去感受。
But we don't experience ourselves.
我们常常做的决策，选的方向，可能跟教会的需要偏离甚远。
Then the choices that we make may be very far from the needs of the church.
所以在这里，尼西米并没有沉浸在这个人的吹捧、欢迎跟礼遇上。
And so here Nehemiah didn't remain in the welcome and, of the people.
他是一个实际亲手做工的人。
He was a practical man of action.
那你跟我今天也是一样。
Today you and I are the same.
教会你不管安排我们什么样的侍奉，什么样的工作。
No matter what the church assigns us to do.
最重要的是要用心的亲手做工。
The most important for us to do is to work with our hands.
我们看回来尼西米记的第二章。
Let's turn back to Nehemiah chapter 2.
第二章的第十七节。
Chapter 2 verse 17.
十七节以后，我对他们说：“我们所遭的那耶路撒冷怎样荒凉，城门被火焚烧，你们都看见了。来吧，我们重建耶路撒冷的城墙，免得再受凌辱。”十八节
，18。
我告诉他们，我神的施恩的手怎样帮助我，并王对我所说的话，他们就说：“我们起来建造吧。”于是他们奋勇做这善工。在这里我们看到了这个尼西米引导百姓的方法。
Here we see how Nehemiah led the Israelites.
他并不是这个浩浩荡荡带着大批的人马，这个威严的来到了耶路撒冷，然后叫别人去做事。
He didn't bring a big multitude of people to Jerusalem and tell everyone else to do the work.
告诉他们说，我可是大官呢，我来这里就是来监督。看你们有没有好好做工。
And say to everyone, I'm an important officer. I'm just here to oversee you all do the work.
在这里说尼西米他是用心查看，看见耶路撒冷真实的景况。
Here Nehemiah used his, was very diligent to see what the true problem was in Jerusalem.
然后召聚会众，大家一起来思考他们目前所面对的难关。
And he congregated everyone together and explained to them what the situation and the difficulties were.
他告诉百姓说，你想一想，这是我们祖宗的城，这是这里有我们神的殿。
He told all the people that this is the land of our fathers, where the temple of our God is.
然后他说了一句说让来吧，我们重建耶路撒冷的城墙。
And then he said, let us build the wall of Jerusalem.
那这句话非常重要。
This phrase is very important.
难道犹大人不知道城墙可以重建吗？
Did the people of Judah not know they could rebuild the wall?
难道犹大人不知道这个焚烧的城墙啊，这个焚烧的城门可以重新搭起来吗？
Did the people of Judah not know that these gates that were burned down could be reset?
啊，但是为什么要等到尼希米来说这句话呢？
Why did they have to wait for Nehemiah to come and tell them this?
因为责任跟压力。
Because of responsibility and pressure.
啊，但是大家都知道问题在哪里。
Everyone knew what the problem was.
啊，大家也知道教会里需要的是什么。
And everyone also knows what the church needs.
啊，教会里面缺乏工人，谁不知道？
The church is lacking workers. Who doesn't know this?
宗教教育系缺乏老师，谁不知道？
The RE education system, religious education system is lacking teachers. Who doesn't know this?
美国的教会缺乏传道，谁不知道？
The churches in America lack pastors. Who doesn't know this?
我们都知道，但是我们总是在等别人去做。
We all know this, but we're all waiting for someone else to do it.
我还记得我的神学院的同学哦，现在英国的加尼传道跟我们说。
I remember that my classmate in TTP, now is Pastor Johnny in the UK, he said to me.
他说啊，他看到啊，教会缺乏工人，非常非常有需要。
He saw that the church was lacking workers and in great need.
所以他就拼命祷告，求神这个啊，求神派遣他的工人啊，能够出来服事。
And so he constantly prayed very diligently for the Lord to send his workers to serve.
主啊，求你选召工人，有这么多优秀的青年，主啊，感动他们，出来吧。
Lord, please choose your workers. We have so many talented youth here. Please choose them and send them to serve.
一年又一年啊，这样子不停的祷告。
And he prayed like this year after year.
祷告了几年之后，他突然想通了。
And after many years, after a couple of years, he finally realized.
他说啊，那这样子没有人，那我就出来吧。
He said that, well, there's no one coming out. Well, I will come out to serve.
很多时候其实需要问题啊，我们都知道啊。
Oftentimes, we all know what the problem is and where the needs are.
但是我们总是祷告求神派别人来解决问题。
But we often pray for God to send others to take care of the problem.
就像有一次有一个弟兄跟我说啊。
So once there was a brother who told me.
为什么教会啊，这个聚会结束啊，都没有人留下来帮忙呢？
And he said, how come after the service is over, no one stays at church to help?
这样不可以啊，怎么可以都没有人留下来帮忙？
This isn't right. How come no one stays to help out at church after?
传道你在讲台上要讲啊。
Pastor, you need to tell everyone on the pulpit.
我听完之后我说哦 ,OK 啊。你要去哪哦聚会完了我要回家了。
And then I said, OK, I'll do it. Where are you going? And then he said, service is over, I'm going home.
所以啊这个传道你要讲啊聚会结束叫大家留下来帮忙做工。但是我有事我要回家了。
So pastor, you need to tell everyone that after service, you need to stay at church and help with the work. But me, I have something to do, so I'm going to go home.
有时候遇到教会的工作，我们讲啊，那个谁啊，找那个有恩赐的啦，啊，找那个比较属灵的啦，找那个预备好的啊，我都不行啊。
And oftentimes with church work, we will say, oh, find that one who is more gifted, that one who is more spiritual. I can't do it.
但是在这里，尼希米说，让我们一起来吧。
But here, Nehemiah said, let us do it together.
所以你跟我今天都可以成为尼希米。
So you and I can both all be Nehemiah today.
与其等待别人站出来，我们为什么不先将自己献上呢？
Instead of waiting for others to come out, why can't we sacrifice ourselves?
不一定是要做全职的传道工人。
It doesn't mean that we absolutely have to be a full-time worker.
但是教会当中的需要，我们难道没有看见吗？
But have we not seen the needs of the church?
所以与其等别人来担负更多的事工。
So instead of waiting for others to take on more holy work,
让我们像尼西米一样勇敢一点说站出来说让我们一起来建造耶路撒冷。
Let us be like Nehemiah and say, let us rise up and build the walls of Jerusalem.
那因为你会看到神的作为，你会见到神的能力。
Because you will be able to see the works and the power of God.
你会看到你小小的一点付出，你愿意额外踏出的这一步，神怎么样使你的生命成为有价值。
You will see how with your little bit of work and your tiny step that God can use it, can work so mightily.
所以在尼西米的鼓励之下，他们就跟着尼西米开始重建这个耶路撒冷的城墙。
So with Nehemiah's encouragement, the people began to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
我们看回来尼西米记三章的第一节。
Let's go to Nehemiah chapter 3.
从第三章开始他们就动手来重新修建城墙。
From Nehemiah chapter 3, the people began to start building the wall.
在这一段当中有几个值得我们思考学习的。
And there are a couple of things here that are worth us to reflect and learn from.
我们先看第三章的第一节。
Let's look at chapter 3 verse 1.
三章第一节。
3 verse 1.
那时大祭司以利亚实和他的弟兄众祭司起来建立羊门分别为圣。所以整个重建的过程第一个记载的是什么？
So when it comes to rebuilding the wall, what is the first thing that is reported?
是谁先站出来？是谁先动手建造？
Who is the first person who came out to start working?
这里叫做以利亚实啊。
It was Eliashib.
以利亚实是大祭司。
Eliashib was the high priest.
所以在他们那个时候没有君王的时代，以利亚实应该是他们里面最大的了。
So there was no king at the time, so Eliashib was probably the most the highest status person.
所以作为回归百姓当中最大最尊贵的人。
So as the one with the high status,
我们却看到大祭司以利亚实先出动开始建造羊门。
We saw that this high priest Eliashib first took the first action to build the sheep gate.
所以在教会里面所谓的领导者跟外面的世界社会是不一样的。
And so leaders in the church are different from leaders in society.
社会当中人追求更高的职位，追求更高的权势，所以他们可以坐在办公椅上叫别人做事。
People in society look to have leadership and management positions so they can sit in their offices and delegate work to others.
但是在这里大祭司以利亚实跟尼西米所留下来的榜样并不是这样。
But the example that Eliashib and Nehemiah left is not so.
他们叫做群羊的榜样走在前头的。
They set an example for the sheep and walked ahead of them.
我们来看彼得前书的第五章。
Let's look at 1 Peter chapter 5.
彼得前书五章的第二节。
1 Peter chapter 5 verse 2.
第二节。
Verse 2.
务要牧养在你们中间神的群羊，按照神旨意照管他们，不是出于勉强，乃是出于甘心，不是出于贪财，乃是出于乐意。第三节。
Verse 3.
也不是辖制所托付你们的。乃是做群羊的榜样。第四节。
Verse 4.
到了牧长显现的时候，你们必得那永不衰残的荣耀冠冕情面。
Shepherd the flock of God which is among you, serving as overseers, not by compulsion, but willingly, not for dishonest gain, but eagerly. 3. Nor being lords over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that does not fade away.
好。所以在这里给我们所有今天侍奉的人一个提醒。
Here's a reminder for all of us who serve today.
教会当中所谓的领导者就是要走在前头做群羊的榜样。
Leaders of the church need to walk ahead of the flock, but be an example.
以身作则，做那个没有人想做的，做那个人家不愿意做的事。
To do the work that no one else wants to do.
叫做额外的劳苦就要得着更多的荣耀。
And if you have this labor, then you will receive the glory.
我们看回来尼希米记的三章。
Let's look at back to Nehemiah chapter 3.
我们看第三章的第十节。
Chapter 3, verse 10.
第十节。
Verse 10.
这里说，其次是哈鲁抹的儿子耶大雅对着自己的房屋修造。这一句话我们可以在尼希米记当中一直不停的看到哦。
We see this phrase constantly in the book of Nehemiah.
像23节这第三章里面这个对着自己的房屋修造这句话出现很多次。
In chapter 3, we see making repairs in front of his house multiple times.
在这里告诉我们他们是怎么样来重修城墙的。
Here it tells us how they rebuilt the walls.
这个耶路撒冷城墙浩大，人却不多。
The walls of Jerusalem were large, and the people working were not very many.
所以他们是先从我家对面的城墙开始修理。
And so they would start making repairs, at the wall right in front of their house.
这告诉我们说，今天我们在建造属灵的城墙，要先从身边做起呀。
And so this tells us that when we are rebuilding our spiritual walls, we need to start with those next to us.
有时候有青年一直跟我说，我要去非洲传福音，我要去非洲传福音。
Oftentimes, youth will tell me, I want to go to preach in Africa.
因为听到一些非洲的见证、神迹、奇事，非常的感动。
Because they were very moved by hearing the testimonies of the miracles and signs in Africa.
所以有一股热心想要到地想要到世界的另外一端，到非洲传福音给那你不认识的人。
And so they have this fervency to go to the other side of the world and preach to those they don't know.
当然，这不是一件什么不好的事。
This is not a bad thing, of course.
但是这里告诉我们说，是不是要先从对着自己房屋的城墙开始修造呢？
But here, does it not tell us that we should start rebuilding in front of our house?
你最好的朋友，你认识十几年的同学，你都没有传福音给他。
You haven't preached to your good friend that you've known for 10 years.
但是你想要这个飞到世界的另外一端，传福音给你一个不认识的人。
But you want to fly to the other side of the world and preach to someone you don't know.
不是不好。
That's not a bad thing.
但是我们是不是要先从身边，从小处着手呢？
But should we not start from those right next to us?
所以在这里讲说，他们先从这个家门口的城墙开始建造。
So here it tells us that they started building right in front of their house.
一方面是告诉我们，这个建造要先从你看得到的小处着手啊。
And so this tells us that when we rebuild, we need to start with those that we can see, to our left and to our right.
你把先看得到的修好，再来慢慢的完成你远大的目标。
Let us first repair what we can see and then start going to larger goals.
第二个是告诉我们，神给你的要求并不多，并不难。
The second thing that it tells us is that God does not require much of us. His requirements are not difficult.
神没有叫你我要把整个耶路撒冷一个人把它盖起来。
The Lord has never required us to build the wall of Jerusalem by ourselves.
你至少门口的，你做得到的，你尽力去做吧。
Just do what you can right in front of your door.
这个是这一段里面给我们的第二个提醒。
This is the second reminder in this passage.
第三个。当每一个人都能够把家门口的城墙修好。
Third is that when each and every one of us are able to repair the wall in front of our own home,
就能够积沙成塔，连接起来，整个城池就得到了保护。
And then connect all these walls together, then the entire city is protected.
有时候我们讲说教会这个不好，教会那个不好。
All the times when I say, this is a problem in the church, and there's another problem here in the church.
有时候有些信徒可能是求好心切，可能是这个为教会感到这个觉得自己是易怒觉得自己我就是担心教会啊。
And sometimes people might be doing this, and they feel that they're having righteous anger for the church.
教会这个不行，那个不好，这个人怎么样，那个人怎么样，义愤填膺就是心里当中觉得说什么都不好。
And they say, oh, there's this problem in the church, there's another problem in the church, this person has problems, that person has problems. And we feel like there's a lot of this righteous anger for things that are going on in the church.
问题很多, 怎么解决?
And there are a lot of problems, and what's the solution?
很简单啊, 从那个意见最多的人开始就好了。
It's easy, just start from the person with the most opinions.
你意见这么多, 那你就先出来帮忙, 先出来做啊。
You have so many opinions, why don't you come out first and do the work?
那你自己做, 每一户都是这样, 如果每一户信徒都说, 那从我自己先改变。
If every member said that, I will start change from myself.
哦, 当你说, 教会为什么都没有慕道者?
If we ever say that, how come there are no truth seekers in church?
啊, 很简单啊, 在你啊, 站起来指的时候, 指出用手指, 指人骂人的时候, 你先说, 那我先去带慕道者啊。
And it's very easy. Before you go out and point fingers out at others, then we should say to ourselves, let's bring truth seekers.
啊, 如果每一户都这样,
if everyone does this,
每一户都是先想说, 那我先去带慕道者啊。
If everyone were to think first, I will go bring a truth seeker.
啊, 你说, 啊, 教会怎么这么脏, 没有人打扫?
If we were to say, the church is so dirty, how come it's no one cleans?
你就是这个先去拿起份, 拿起本机, 拿起扫把, 拿起本机, 你先开始做, 教会就会越来越好啊。
Then you should be the first person to grab the broom and the dustbin and start to work,
啊,
and the church will become better.
如果每一个人都用这种心理来做事,
if everyone had this type of heart to do the work,
我先把我家里门口的那一段城墙修好,
who to first mend and repair that wall right in front of my house.
啊, 然后教会里面的每一户都能够把这个城墙盖好。
And if every household is able to mend this wall in front of their house,
啊,
and build it,
连接起来, 我们就有了耶路撒冷的保护。
Then connected, we are protecting the city of Jerusalem.
啊, 所以教会的侍奉不是一两个人能够做什么的。
And so the servitude in the church is not about one or two people doing the work.
啊, 如果每一个人都将教会的工当做自己的责任,
if everyone were to take the work of the church as their own responsibility,
啊, 那我们就能够看到这耶路撒冷再一次的得到荣耀。
Then we will once again see the glory of Jerusalem.
啊, 所以从这尼西米来到, 啊, 来到耶路撒冷, 这个, 啊, 城墙的重新建造。
And so when we see how Nehemiah came to Jerusalem to how the wall of Jerusalem was built,
啊, 我们看到他所面对的现实环境困难跟挑战非常的多。
We saw that he faced many challenges.
但是人有决心,
but he had determination.
加上祷告求神施恩怜悯帮助,
as well as the addition of praying to God for, to have mercy and grace to help him.
我们今天就看到了超越, 超越现实的神的能力。
So today we are able to see this power, overwhelming power of God.
啊, 在经过两年的休息沉寂之后,
after 2 years,
啊, 是我们也该重新起来要来建造的时刻了。
After 2 years of resting in the pandemic, we must also rise and build.
啊, 教会有很多工作需要你的帮助。
There's much work in the church that requires your help.
啊, 求主耶稣感动我们大家。
May the Lord move every one of us.
因为教会的工就是我们的事。
Because the work of the church is our duties.
我们一起来做聚会结束的祷告。
We're going to kneel down and pray together.
一起来祷告。
Let's pray together.